ran a mile every day for 30 days, and here's what happened.
Here's proof that I did it.
Gonna run.
I never want to run again. It was so much fun. I really enjoyed that.
By the way, make sure to subscribe if you're not already, and head over to my Instagram, follow me, and enter my $100 Target gift card giveaway. Do it.
It's officially day one. I'm honestly really nervous. I have not ran in, oh my gosh, like 5 years, 6 years. I haven't ran a mile in that long.
I'm going to do a little walk first to warm up, and then I'm gonna start running.
Excuse me if I pant. So I'm getting kind of mixed reviews.
This is my treadmill I bought off Amazon. It was the cheapest one I could find. I started running after I was at 0.1 miles of walking, and that was only a minute. This said I ran a mile in 11 and a half minutes.
Watch told me that I ran 1 mile in 12 minutes, 52 seconds. So basically, I died during that. I had to take quite a few breaks. I had to get off my treadmill and get some water. And when I stopped, I turned the counting off. Maybe I should have kept it on, because if I'm running in person and I stop, I guess I'll be counted.
I'm sort of embarrassed of this because I used to run a lot faster.
Day two, let's go.
That was so hard, oh my god.
That sucked. I definitely still had to walk for a minute. I think the thing that's my curve right now is letting myself walk when I know I can run.
I accidentally ran a little bit more than a mile. Genuinely, I have no idea how.
I can do faster for shorter, but it gets me further. I walked a lot today. I don't like jogging, I might as well sprint. Only day three and we're improving.
Day four, let's go.
That was genuinely the worst experience of my entire life.
I never want to run again.
This is the data for my very first attempt. Not bad. And this is the data for my second run. Not my best.
I'm so nervous. I'm gonna run in person.
I'm so nervous.
I've never really ran in person, and I'm afraid that I'm gonna see people I know, or that someone's gonna be like, she doesn't know how to run, because I'm afraid. Oh my gosh, I've never just ran in person, so I don't know how this is gonna go. The only times I've ever like ran not on a treadmill in my PE classes. Oh my god, I'm so nervous. My stomach is like turning. I'm nervous.
It's pretty though. Here's the data for this one.
Honestly, that went so well. I was really hoping this challenge would turn me into one of those girls who loves to go on runs on the treadmill. I was like, heck no. But I actually enjoyed this. I think it helped that there was like a pretty view. I just like went back and forth like 4 times. I'm excited to come back tomorrow and do it again. Gonna run. It was such a hassle to get here this morning, but it was so much fun. I really enjoyed that. Look at that. I'm kind of blind, so I can't read it in the viewfinder. 10:29 mile. I never thought I would be impressed by that. I'm improving.
Day 7, let's go. Not my best mile time, but I am really proud of the fact that I woke up on a Sunday morning and did this.
I think what matters right now is that I'm having fun.
Kind of. I would like my mile time to improve, but I'm also having fun.
My mile time keeps getting worse. That was hard. Walking back to my car. Can you even see it in this lighting? I don't think so. Dang it. My mile time was 10:38 for 1.02 miles. I thought my mile time would be like 10:20, 10:19. Because it felt so much harder today, but I guess not. I ran on this bridge and I was really proud I didn't stop the whole way up. And I might have ran like a fourth back, but I'm pretty proud of myself.
Another pretty view for you. At night, that lights up. It's really pretty.
Happy day 10. I'm at my parents' house, which means I get to bring a... Hey, don't cry. We're going soon. I'm just telling them that I'm bringing you. Come on. Are you excited?
Come on. We just finished though. Went pretty well. She's a lot better of a runner than I am. Oh, no, that is not our house. Try telling me she's not the cutest thing ever. Not my best, but definitely not my worst. I'm not even halfway done with the run, but I needed to pause and break, so I paused my Apple Watch so I could collect myself. All the way that bridge, all the way across, all the way to there. Today was rough.
Here's day 13.
Day 14, and I finally ran under a 10-minute mile.
I'm so proud of myself.
Not too bad for day 15. Day 16, 9:55. Day 17. Day 18.
Not my best time, but in my defense, I was walking because I was kind of nosy because it kind of looks like they found a dead body or there was some sort of crime scene on the lake that I walk by or run by. I contribute this to me being nosy and walking so I could see what's going on.
Day 18. Day 19. Day 20, my fastest time yet.
Really weird, but one thing I learned is that I run the fastest to the album 1989 by Taylor Swift. Good to know.
day 23.
One thing I'm noticing is my stamina is getting so much faster. Like, I can just run for a lot longer than I used to without getting exhausted.
Day 22, it was an 8:58 mile, I swear. It just took me 2 seconds to pause it, because when it showed up and said 1 mile done, it said 8:58.
So I broke 9 minutes, but technically the data recorded disagrees.
Day 23, day 24, eh. I hurt my hip, so this was definitely more of a fast walk than a run. I think I'm injured because I can't go very fast. Day 27.
I really hurt myself, you guys. And I keep saying like, okay, tomorrow I'll just, it'll be fine. It's not that big of a deal. I'll work out, I'll run, and I'll run it off. No, I'm not running it off. It's so painful. If you guys hurt yourself, don't run on it. But I'm not taking my own advice because I'm so close to being done. I just want to be done. Really hurt. It just is, oh my God.
Day 28. Day 29, one more day to go.
Today's day 30, it is my last day. I genuinely mean this when I say that I never thought this challenge would end. Never been more excited to run just to get this over with.
Day 30, we're done.
Wow, it is such a good feeling being done with this.
This was definitely one of the hardest things I've ever had to do. I have not ran since I was a freshman in high school for my PE class, and now I'm a junior in college. I don't run. Running isn't my choice of cardio. I've never liked it. This was such a challenge, so please don't judge me on my mile time. I feel like it's not that great, but like, you know why now. I don't run. I'm sure you guys are all curious if I lost weight, how my body changed throughout this 30 days. My weight literally stayed the exact same, but I did do this over the holidays, so that could be a reason why. A lot of people also gained weight during the holidays, and I stayed the same. So maybe it just kind of like leveled it out. My calories went here, that makes no sense. You know, that is a possibility. I was talking to someone and they were like, yeah, no kidding, you didn't lose weight. You have to run more than just like 10 minutes a day to do something. And I was like, that's a really good point. I do eat ice cream for dinner quite a bit. I don't know how people lose weight doing this. If you guys are like wanting to do like a weight loss challenge, I recommend drinking a gallon of water a day for a week. I did a video on it. I lost so much weight in 7 days. It was actually like insane. If you're here for some weight loss tip, go to that video. That video might be more helpful. Let's talk about my mile time. My highest mile time is like the 20 minute one, where we had a whole dilemma. I'm just gonna start with my first mile time to my best mile time. My first was 12:52, which I was like embarrassed about. Oh my God, 13 minute mile. My lowest mile was 8:37, which that's the fastest mile I've ever run my entire life. Before that, 9 minutes flat was my fastest mile. I'm just not a fast runner. I improved 4 minutes and 15 seconds. That is insane. I definitely felt as I was going on, my stamina was increasing a lot and I could run for a lot further and not get as exhausted as I would. This challenge was exactly what it is. It's a challenge, meaning like, yes, it is really freaking hard, but it also is a challenge. I don't consider it like a sustainable lifestyle thing. You can't, like, it doesn't work like this. This isn't something you can do every day. The water video where you drink a gallon of water a day, I feel like you could do that every day. This, you can't do it every day of your life. You need rest days. You can't be running every single day of your life. I don't think that's good for you. It also just does not work for my lifestyle. I think it could be sustainable to run 5 days a week. I will be honest, this did take me more than 30 days to do it. It wasn't possible. There's a moment where I thought I had COVID, so I wanted to wait for my test results back. It's been a few days. I thought I had COVID. My lifestyle got in the way of it. Every morning, waking up at a certain amount of time, go running. It doesn't work every single day like that. Sometimes you have prior commitments, or sometimes you have something going on, or you get injured like I did. I think you need a lot of motivation to wake up early every day for 30 days to go running. But I did the best I could, so I hope you guys are okay with that. Now, also, I wanted to say this. If you're a girl and you're going running like in person on a track, by a lake, by a park, couple reminders that I wanted to give you guys. Make sure you're running during the day. I never ran at night. It's a scary world out there. Make sure you're listening to your music at like a low volume so you can hear what's going on around you. You can also go with a friend, that might be safer. And just overall, be careful. Just be aware of your surroundings. It's a scary world out there. I also have not ran since I stopped this challenge. I told myself I was going to and I never have. I don't know if I ever will run again. So overall, would I recommend that you guys run a mile every day for 30 days? No. I would recommend maybe doing 5 days a week, but every day for 30 days is just not sustainable and you get burnt out so fast, and I don't want that for you guys. Definitely exercise, but also take your rest days and take time to recuperate so you don't get injured. I don't know if you guys have ever heard of the 13-3-30. You're on a treadmill, 13 incline, 3 speed, 30 minutes. I've heard great stories of people doing that. They've lost so much weight and gotten such great shapes. I definitely want to try it, so let me know if you guys want me to do like a video of me doing it for a month. Maybe a more sustainable way than 30 days straight. I hope that you guys like this video. If you did, give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe if you're not already. I'd love to have you here. Also follow me on Instagram so you can go enter my giveaway. I love you guys so much and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!